In today's example, we're going to look at a file that comes from a bank that includes these fields. It has the transaction date, a document number that was paid, and then also the amount that was paid. So in NetSuite terms, this is a payment of $2,488.67 against invoice number 1267. So what we want to do is actually take this bank file and then build a deposit record that would mirror something like this, where we go through and check off each one of these that actually matched and then go ahead and click save. So that's going to be our mission today. In order to move this deposit from Excel up to NetSuite, we're going to use a CloudExtend deposit record. So here are the header level fields, and here's some line level fields that I'm bringing in here as well. Now, please note that the only required field that we're going to bring information in from the bank is this payment list ID, and this must be the internal ID of the transaction record. So in other words, it's going to be the internal ID for this particular invoice number 1267. So in order to get that data, we're going to use our save search. We're going to bring in a list of payments that have not yet been deposited, and then we'll do a VLOOKUP against those records, and we'll pull in the internal ID, and we'll add it over here. So here I'm going to click the menu icon. I'm going to go to save searches, and we're going to look for all of the transaction-based save searches that are in this account. They're all going to load here, and then I'm going to be able to use this search icon to go ahead. I'm just going to start looking for payment. So here's payments not deposited. This is a NetSuite save search that I've created. We'll take a look at that in just a second. We're going to go ahead and download that data. And you'll see all those search results will stream right in here. So I'm saving the step of going into NetSuite and doing an export, save as CSV, and then copy and paste into Excel over here. So here you can see the transaction number 1274. And then this is the internal ID of that transaction number inside of NetSuite. So let's flip over to NetSuite and take a look at that search. So in this case, since a cash payment could also show up in deposits, and we're using cash payments in this test drive account, I'm including cash payment, cash sales, and payments. And then I'm looking for specific statuses, so cash sales that haven't been deposited and payments that haven't been deposited. And then I'm bringing in these results here, transaction number, name, status, and then I'm renaming internal ID using a custom label, and then the same thing for payment amount. Now here, I just added a VLOOKUP to the bank record. So this is the file that came from the bank. I just inserted a column. Now we're doing a VLOOKUP, and we're looking up the value in cell B2, so 1267, and we're looking up that value from the undeposited payment, and we're returning column 4. So in this case, this is the internal ID 23. So if we flip, come back over to the bank data, you can see here's that match, and we're returning the value 23. So now it's time to load our bank deposit template. And now all we need to do is populate these values. I'm just gonna go to the bank data field, and I'm gonna pull in all this data right here. The transaction numbers. We're going to take those, we're going to pop those right here into the payment list ID, and we're going to do a pay special as values. We'll get rid of that formula. Now next, I can actually use formulas if I wanted to. So if I want to use a formula to bring in that date, I could, but I know the date is 4/26/19. So I'm just going to come back over to the template, and I'm going to put in 4/26/19, and we're just going to copy this value all the way down to the bottom of the sheet. Now, the account is the bank account that this is going to be going into. So I'm going to view account details over here, and I'm going to look for a checking account. So I'm just going to copy that checking account, and I'm going to paste that down to the end of my table as well. And in this particular test drive account, a location is a required field. So I'm going to enter the location here as well, and we'll drop that all the way down as well. Now, this field over here, payment list deposit, this is going to be set to be true, and I'll show you the equivalent of this in NetSuite in just a second. So we're going to drop that all the way down. And if we look at a deposit record in NetSuite, setting this field on is true and off is false. So all we're really doing on that, on this particular with here is just setting off that checkbox to true or false. So now we actually have all the information that's needed. Every other field here does not need to be entered. In fact, it shouldn't be entered because you can't change the payment amount. That's really referencing this payment amount here. So that's not editable. We're going to just use that for reference only once the transaction's created. I'm going to go right over here. I'm going to just click on update, and I'm going to choose update one more time. And this will take all the records in this table, and it'll build a bank deposit. And then we'll go take a look at that over in NetSuite. So we get the internal ID turning over to green here. We know it's one bank deposit because it's the same internal ID. I can now click on refresh, and that's going to go out and it's going to fill in the rest of these fields. It's going to go out to NetSuite and say, hey, fill in all the fields that were auto-populated when you created that deposit. One key thing to note here is this true false value. So true means these payments were actually deposited. False means they still show up on the deposit, but they're not deposited yet. So let's go take a look at that deposit inside NetSuite, and I think you'll see what I mean. Now I'm going to go ahead and click on list so we get to our most recent deposit. So here it is, April 25th, 19. I'm going to go ahead and first click view, and you can see all of the lines that were added to that deposit. And now I'm going to click on edit, and that's what we're seeing on the other side inside of Excel. So you can see that you still have all these other values that you could add to the deposit if you wanted to. So that's kind of it in a nutshell. I hope this video and the accompanying article will help someone out there work a little bit faster. Thanks so much for watching.